In this book that I've published on the Lulu website, I've published a circuit from a sawtooth generator. And this is that circuit. It's on page 44. And here you see that circuit completely. In fact, it's very, very simple, easy to make. Don't worry. We have here a stabilizer made with the BD139. That is in fact a series transistor with a Zener diode at its base to ground. That means that we have here a stabilized voltage from, say, 12 volts. That's always necessary in oscillator circuits, because an oscillator is only stable with a stabilized voltage. When the voltage changes, the frequency changes. And here we have that circuit. We all know the properties from a sawtooth generator. A capacitor is charged, and on a certain moment it is very quickly shortcut by a transistor or whatever, and then the charge falls down from its maximum level to zero. So a slowly charge up and then a suddenly charge down. There's a lot to tell, by the way, how a sawtooth generator works, especially about the linearity from the charging. A capacitor does not always charge in a linear way, and that gives a problem. But anyway, all these problems are avoided with this circuit. Here we have a few capacitors, and here you see how that capacitors influence the frequency. So the first capacitor, 100 microfarad, gives a frequency band from 0.05 hertz up to 0.5 hertz, etc. And the total frequency band from this square wave, sawtooth generator, goes from 0.05 hertz up to 50 kilohertz, so 50,000 hertz. And that's quite good. For simple oscilloscope circuits, this is a perfect sawtooth generator and a perfect time-based circuit. It was published in relation to this schematic, a basic oscilloscope. When you want to make a basic oscilloscope that can work from, say, 0.5 hertz up to, say, 50 kilohertz or so, or 100 kilohertz. This is a useful circuit. And this is the time-based generator. That is, in fact, a sawtooth generator that drives the dot on the screen from the left to the right. And here you can see how that dot is driven by adding a voltage to a high voltage diode, the 2SC2333 NPN transistor. This generator has an output from approximately maximum 9 volts. It drives this high voltage transistor. That high voltage transistor drives a dot on the screen. Anyway, go to my book for more information. This is perhaps interesting. I've made here a circuit with which you can synchronize the time. And here is a reversed NPN transistor that shortcuts the first transistor here. That's important for the sawtooth frequency. And by driving that first transistor, that synchronizing transistor, on its base, the whole time-based circuit, the sawtooth generator, is synchronized to the dot on the screen, and that's very, very important, because otherwise it's not possible to make a certain waveform stand still on the oscilloscope screen. So synchronizing is necessary. These two diodes protect this transistor from being damaged by a too high synchronizing pulse. And also, of course, this potmeter, potentiometer. But of course you can, when you want to use such a sawtooth generator in general, you can omit this part of the circuit, the synchronizing transistor circuit, and use this for other purposes. It's a very properly working circuit with very low frequencies, going to 50 kilohertz. That's quite a high frequency for hobby use, and it's in fact very easy to make. So that was all to tell.